In this lab, we'll focus on a nice biological example which talks about sustained oscillations in glycolysis, and we will see how we can use MATLAB and, you know, the models are already available online at BioModels to build and simulate such systems. So this is a paper that talks about sustained oscillations in glycolysis. And you find interesting outputs like this. So these are, okay, this is some experimental values. Let's look at, yeah, so this is perturbations with some UTP and you know, for different species and so on. So let's look at the, you have all the equations here. Can you now implement these? A dx dt dot m, right? A function that will give you the, that will compute your dx by dt is f of x, except that here x is a vector, vector of several concentrations and so on, right? So let's just take a step aside. What is dA by dt? dA by dt will be just, it will be minus V1 equals dB by dt, dC by dt V1 minus V2, dD by dt V2. Is that fine? Very simple, right? So there is a way to represent this. You can just say d by dt equals, this is phi cross 1 2 cross 1, we need a phi cross 2 matrix that connects the 2, right? And here I would basically just put minus 1, minus 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 1, 1. Straightforward, just matrices. Right, or I would say dx by dt equals s into v. This is a matrix actually known as the stoichiometric matrix. This is central to the next module of the course when we talk about flux balance analysis and constraint based methods for studying metabolic networks, but this is very important to know right here. Why? Because these are your differential equations. If you are able to write expressions for all the V's, you can simulate it. Let's go back. Here are the expressions for all the V's, right? So your reactions are GLC plus ATP giving F6P plus ADP, F6P plus ATP giving FBP plus ADP. So you have to carefully identify the coefficients for each of these. If you look at this a little more closely, what are these coefficients in this matrix? The stoichiometric coefficient negative for reactants, positive for products. That's it. So you don't have to actually worry about writing these equations out. You really don't have to worry about writing out all these equations, right? So you can basically, the moment I give you a list of reactions, you can directly write out the stoichiometric matrix, which is what you can do in this example potentially. You'll have to hand code everything. So thankfully somebody has already done this. So if you look at, so this kind of a file is available from biomodels.net. And in fact, this is a very interesting file. So biomodels also allows you to give you an get an SBML report, a PDF report of any SBML file. It has curated several SBML files. So it calls this file Nielsen 1998 Glycolysis, and this has a lot of details. This is essentially from the SBML, right? If you remember SBML from a few classes ago. So the compartment, well, let's just cut to the chase. These are your species. So you want to do a DAT by DT, a DADP by DT, DAMP by DT, all of these. These are all your parameters. They are in the manuscript, which I was just showing you. And these are all your reactions. These are your ATP input, source and sink reactions, but these are your main reactions. It you have about 10 reactions, and the good part is it already gives you V1 equals volume of compartment, you can keep that as 1 if you want, is 3.5 minus ATP into flow. Right, let's look at, so this is our ATP flow, let's look at the other reactions. This is essentially a stoichiometric matrix, derived from the stoichiometric matrix. So V16 is this, reaction 2 is this, which is this, you need to write those out. Let's skip to the metabolites. Very nice. DATP by DT is V1, that is also hyperlinked by the way, you can just click it and go to V1, right. So DNAD by DT is V4 plus V23 minus V19, DF6P by DT is V16 minus V6 minus V17 minus 25 and so on, and all these have been defined previously. What is V25? It is here. So biomodel actually gives you files for Octave, not for MATLAB. You can just make a few small tweaks and use it with MATLAB. There are also other tools that you can use it with. So how does this look? I would recommend this architecture for any ODE solving problem. You first set up a file just like we had in the previous example, ode.m, or rather analyze the ODE and your dx by dt, which is basically something like the ODE of the model, model ode.m, right. So I have something like that here. So I have ode model underscore 42.m and analyze model underscore 42.m. 42 happens to be the biomodel's ID for this particular Nielsen glycolysis model. And then you code all these parameters. All these parameters are available in the manuscript if you look at it carefully. the next page. Right. So, it says V 1 is 0.5, K 1 GLC is 0.1 millimolar, K 10 is 0.05 per second and so on and so forth. We have all these values that are listed here. And so it goes. You have all the equations listed here. X dot 1 is this, X dot 2 is this, X dot 15 is this. Now, you can actually solve this. You can use analyze model 42.m to solve it. What do you need to do here? First is set up the initial conditions, then create a vector where you want to simulate it. Then basically the same old thing, t comma y is ODE 15s of ODE model 42 t comma y naught.
So, what is y?
Y or x? Yeah, you can probably have it as x here. Yes, so let's just run this. You see, much like the same oscillation that is there in the paper, right? Something of this sort. The equations, can we look at the MAT equations? So, basically call them as x dot is f of t comma x. Essentially, you can get it from the stoichiometric matrix. So, this is a vector having x 1 dot, x 2 dot, x 3 dot, all your species.
So, we have 5. Okay, so we need 5 initial conditions.
Not 5. So, here there are many more metabolites. There are 15 metabolites.
So, we will need 15.
You have 15 initial conditions if you look up.
Okay.
The initial conditions will be set up here. X 1 is ATP, X 2 is ADP, X 3 is AMP, GLC, F6, PB, FBP, so on, ETOH, right. So, all your glycolysis parameters and phosphate, whatever, all the metabolites involved in glycolysis, bisphosphoglycerate, phosphoenol pyruvate, pyruvate acetate, ethanol, glyceraldehyde phosphate.
So, from X dot equation we can see that ATP is present in B1 reaction 1, reaction 2, reaction 3, reaction 6 and reaction 9.
Reaction 1?
So, ATP will be there in reaction 1, reaction 2, reaction 5, reaction 6 and reaction 9,
yes,
sir.
1, 2.
ATP first and extract. 1.
And barrels?
So, whatever velocities it is having, the rates.
Right, right. Yeah. Yeah.
Then what is ATP? ATP flows?
That's like an input sort of.
Okay.
To the whole system. Yeah. Because if you need a steady state of glycolysis, you need a steady supply of ATP, right?
Okay.
ATP and all of these actually in steady state. So, this model is described in great detail in this paper and also all the mathematical details are basically, in fact, this is very interesting, all this information is encoded inside your SBML file. this is just literally an SBML to PDF kind of routine that was run to extract all this information out. So it's actually done by SBML to LaTeX.
X dot should be a should contain variable in terms of that x only, right? X dot of 1 should be in terms of x 1.
No.
Not necessarily.
If it is.
It is multidimensional, right? So no problem. See, if you remember the very first slide for today.
Okay.
Dxi by dt is fi of x 1 to n. Doesn't matter. So you will have to figure this out, right? You have to try out a few examples. It's not difficult, but it involves rigor. You have to be very careful. You can't make like some minus 1 plus 2 mistakes kind of thing. You have to rigorously set up the equations, then you can simulate them nicely. I'll share these files with you, it will become clearer. You need to take a look at this file again. This analyze model, ODE model, all of these files I'll share with you. Good. Any questions?
So there is actually a ODE package in Octave. If these models are working in Octave only, it can be just with Octave's ODE package.
Yeah. So the file is same. So you can obviously just download the M file from BioModels and run it on Octave even.
So no, you told these are. Written for Octave, we have to make some tweaks to get it.
Yeah, so I made some tweaks already.
Okay.
Some very minor tweaks, but you can just do a bunch of find and replaces kind of thing, you will be able to run it in MATLAB. So I hope you had a good overview of how one uses MATLAB to work with models on biomodels.net to run simulations and plot graphs and so on. The next video, we will start looking at parameter optimization or parameter estimation, which is an optimization problem essentially. And we will also have a brief overview of biochemical systems theory just before we get started with parameter estimation.